Today's Saturday morning. These are all fresh ones for the last couple of weeks. So we've had a complete whiteout over the last week. It's just not been worth filming anything for you. The 18th, there was a complete whiteout and they had that big rainstorm in Poole. Or in, where was it? Poole, yeah. So it just, you know, thick cloud. And that's it, that's what we've got this morning. This is the 20th of August. Pretty early in the morning, it's, no one else is up yet. There's the moon hiding behind the chemtrail clouds. So that was probably something to do with last night, maybe. So that doesn't look very healthy up there. Shame you can't really see that on the video. That dark patch looks like a nasty sooty patch of cloud. All of that does up there is pull that back. Cloud the stupid lights in the way. But yeah, chemtrails. Apparently I've been reading a report, I had a scan through a report, I'm going to read it properly and do a response to it, from the House of Commons and all the various people involved in it. And this chemtrail business, people, is going to last for hundreds of years, apparently. They're even going to, they've proposals to build, I mean, this is a serious project, proposals to build a wire mesh mirror, which is going to be something, I don't know, something enormous bloody great thing in space to block the sun's rays from hitting the surface of the Earth. In the excuse that it's going to reduce global warming, which has already been exposed as a scam. And if you just type in climate change fraud, you'll see lots of videos and various people have done lots of good research on it. And the other thing is that if you look up about carbon dioxide, you'll notice actually that when they grow fruit and flowers, 90% of all flowers that you buy in shops are grown hydroponically. That's how you can feed the world, by the way, when there's a problem with growing food in the soil. If there's a problem with that, you just grow it hydroponically. They've had that for 50,000 years or something like that. The Hanging Gardens of Babylon, and probably going way back further than that, you know. So today, or in the olden days, in times gone by, right, wait a minute, there was a lot more CO2 on the planet, and the plants are much more luscious, and the people who grow fruit and flowers for sale, they're called a C3 plant. That's what the category that they fall into. They like a lot of light. They actually have extra CO2 put into the places where they're grown because they will yield double the amount of CO2. So there's not actually enough CO2 in the atmosphere as it is for the plants that are on the planet. But they're telling us that there is too much CO2 on the planet. And that is completely the 180 degrees reverse of the reality. If there was more CO2, there would be more plants out there absorbing CO2 and circulating it through the life cycle. I'm going to do a proper report on that so I can get my, so I don't ramble on about things and try and draw it out of my memory. I'll plan that one and do it. But there's another example of just the utter psychosis of the government and the money and what it will do to, you know, PhDs, government ministers, media hacks, the Royal Society, you know, I can't remember the group that they call it in the government, the think tank for climate science. It's just crazy. Read the report. It's on It's out there. I'm going to link it onto this video anyway. But here we go. So thanks again, British government, and all you doctors and philosophers. We've got all your names because they're on the report. So we'll be knocking on your door at some point, saying, what the fuck are you doing? In fact, we'll just get the coppers to do that, to come and arrest you once we've explained to them the reality of the situation of what you're doing and how you're getting funded. Because I should think that that's a criminal fraud in itself, particularly now that the all the evidence has come out about the fraud of Al Gore and his film and how fallacious it all was anyway. There you go. Just trying to get a picture of the red sky in the morning across the sky, across the clouds, underneath. It doesn't really come up that well on the video, but it's quite impressive. I mean, is it just when using your eyes? There's another chemtrail plane up there. 5 o'clock, 5:30 in the morning it is, this morning. And here's the evidence, peeps. That's what they've started to do now, 5:30 in the morning. Before they were coming over at about 10 o'clock. I don't think it is a chemtrail jet. Hang on a minute, let's see what happens to his trail. I think it might be disappearing, that one, actually. I think that's just a normal jet. I think the trails. No, I think that's just a normal jet over there. He's gone. No, that's a normal jet. But what we had lower down there, you see, that's not normal jet trails. I'm glad I took the other video because those other ones have gone now. You can't even see them anymore. So, with a bit of support from the people, we can stop this. Otherwise, your children's 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 children are going to be experiencing this, and they won't know what the hell this is and when it started, and they won't know what a normal sky looks like by that point, which is how they get away with all the wars, getting everyone to think that they're natural as well, and we've always been fighting wars. Well, that's not so either. It's only in the last 1,000 years that we've been fighting the wars, or 2,000 years. If you listen to people like Michael Tsarian, there were times of peace on this planet, but we're just indoctrinated to think that we're all animals and that we can only fight. And that's not true either. We're not animals at all. We're the sentient life on this planet that takes care of it and all other life on the planet. And the other life on the planet takes care of us symbiotically. But we're all too busy screaming and shouting at each other to get over the hump, as they say, I suppose. There you go. heavy rain this morning and this afternoon. Well, they were up this morning at 5:30, so you could see them. But there we go. Chemtrails, it's the Bournemouth air show today, so we've seen the Lancaster just come over. And they're not even stopping for their own air shows, which is quite surprising. So, British government, thanks very much. Multi-£1 million operation, wasting taxpayers' money, again. Like I said, people, they've planned it. You need to read that report, because they've planned this to go on for hundreds of years. All because of Al Gore and his lies. Thinking they know about creation more than anyone else. I mean, it really is despotism at its finest. And there you go. So we've had some sun, even though they tried to block it, so fuck you, British government, and all you people who are involved in that. It didn't work today. You lost out. And, well, as I say, the consequences, you're not going to choose what's going to happen to you. And that is the evidence right there, in case anyone doesn't notice. Preparing for Sunday. I can't really see the viewfinder, so I hope this is about right. It's there somewhere. That's what he's done. In the sky. Another one right overhead. Another one doing it there. After the sun cleared it all. See what I'm doing now. There you go. That's what's been done today. It's come down a bit. It was a beautiful blue sky this afternoon. We don't really know what's going on up there. There we go. And that one there, that's the one I filmed earlier, across the beach. Stand next to something. Wobble.